Planet Dolan.
If the Earth stopped spinning, what continent would be almost completely underwater? How many oceans would we end up with? These are 10 of the things you could look forward to if the world stopped turning. I'm Melissa, and today I'll be your narrator. Number 10. Wind blows everything away. The most dramatic world stops turning scenario is if the planet just stops spinning suddenly, all at once, like someone hit the emergency brake. If the planet suddenly stops spinning, the air in the atmosphere wouldn't. The Earth normally spins at a rate of 1,100 miles per hour. Stopping that would result in, basically, 1,100 mile per hour winds across most of the planet. Severe hurricanes struggle to reach 200. That means basically everything not attached to bedrock, including trees and buildings, would get ripped up from the ground and launched somewhere. Luckily, the force wouldn't be quite enough to throw everything into space. Also luckily, this scenario is pretty much physically impossible. Number 9. Messed up day-night cycles. Our 24-hour night-day cycle is a result of the Earth having its own unique rotational cycle. If it stopped, we would end up with 6 months of daytime and 6 months of nighttime. See, the Earth would still orbit the Sun, but if it stopped rotating on its axis, the side that faced the Sun would depend entirely on where Earth was in orbit. The much more likely situation is that the Earth ends up with a Sun-synchronous rotation. Basically, that it rotates once every 365 days, consistent with its orbit. This would result in one side of the planet having constant daytime and the other being an eternal night. Number 8. Oceans slide to the poles. The arrangement of land and water we now see is a result of the Earth's rotational gravity. That's why there's such a thing as high and low tide. Changing that wouldn't just put us in constant high tide or low tide. It would change the entire world map. The oceans would shift to where the gravitational energy is strongest, the North and South Poles. That would result in massive flooding, putting almost everything north of Chicago underwater. Meanwhile, a massive, singular continent would open up along the equator, creating a massive canyon between the continents, rather than an ocean. Florida, Cuba, and Mexico would all be connected by land. Number 7. Two different sea levels. Because all of the world's oceans are connected today, the entire world shares roughly the same sea level. But if the ocean slid to the poles, we would simply have a northern ocean and a southern ocean. Since there would be no connection between the oceans, each polar ocean would have its own sea level. For a number of reasons, it's likely that the northern ocean would end up with a sea level about a mile higher than the southern ocean, which is partially why the northern hemisphere would lose drastically more landmass. Number 6. Europe mostly disappears. The ocean migration would put nearly all of Canada and Russia underwater. The same goes for almost the entire continent of Europe. With the exception of some southern Balkan states around Turkey, Europe as we know it would be completely washed away. The UK, Germany, France, all of Scandinavia, all underwater. The only surviving bits would be some of the highest peaks of the Alps and other mountain ranges, which would pop up as small mountainous islands. Oh, and Spain. Spain would actually mostly be fine. Number 5. Australia gets a land bridge. Australia is an island whose ecosystem is entirely unlike anything else because you can't get to it by land. But a post-rotation Australia would create a land bridge between Australia, Indonesia, and what remains of Asia. On top of that, Australia itself would lose almost none of its actual landmass since the southern sea level would be roughly a mile lower than that of the north. Then, they would have to say goodbye to Tasmania, though. Number 4. The shape of the Earth changes. Never mind the topography of the Earth's surface. The whole shape of the Earth would change if it stopped spinning. The Earth's current rotation makes the Earth not a perfect sphere. It's a sort of flattened sphere with a bulge around the center. That bulge is a result of centripetal force, which would cease to be if the world stopped spinning. The migration of the oceans would eliminate the so-called equatorial bulge, and the Earth would eventually become a perfect sphere. Number 3. Africa actually gets bigger. As a continental landmass, Africa would be mostly unchanged by this series of events. Most of its actual land would remain above water. On top of that, Madagascar would become connected to the continental mainland.
I like to move it, move it. Yeah, I like to move it.
Basically, Africa would look the same, but with extra landmasses on the north, east, and west. It would be by far the largest remaining continent on Earth, putting aside the fact that the entire world would basically consist of just one huge landmass and two huge oceans. Number 2. Weather moves north to south. We already know that it's hotter at the equator than the North or South Pole. But because of the Earth's rotation, the 24-hour day-night cycle and movement of air across the Earth's surface keeps things somewhat regulated. If that stopped, air would eventually stop moving in its usual west-to-east pattern, and temperature differences would become extreme from the equator towards the poles. Even going a short distance north or south would create extreme temperature differences, and warm air would naturally start moving towards colder areas. This means weather systems that generally cycle from the equator towards the north and south poles and back, rather than circling the globe as they do now. Number 1. Basically everything dies. Assuming any life on Earth survived the initial cataclysm, the new 12-month day-night cycle would make it very difficult to stay in one place for long. One side of the Earth would see about 6 months of constant exposure to the sun, while the other would be deprived of heat and light for just as long. That means most of the planet would either be freezing or boiling at any given point. That would almost certainly likely be too much for the ecosystem to adapt to, and anything that survived would slowly go extinct by either extreme temperatures or starvation. On that happy note, remember that you'll never see any of this stuff happen, but you can tell us which of these things you think might be kinda cool in the comments below, and we'll pin our favorite to the top. Thanks for watching! Catch you guys next time!